All right, so last time everything went wrong. And everybody died. Except for like my party, Seymour. But, like, everybody died. We had this.
A swift retreat. Satisfied?
Oh, jeez.
What do you mean?
Those who turned from Yevon died, while the faithful live on.
Ha!
The past 10 years have changed you, I see.
Interesting. Warren doesn't trust him at all.
You do not look so well. But now, more than ever, you must be the people's strength, their confidence. Anyone else would be expected to show their sorrow.
But you must show determination,
but
huh?
You are a summoner. You are Spira's hope.
But he can summon.
Until sin is defeated, you must not relent. Do you understand?
Yes. I understand.
Are you afraid? Yuna, take me as your pillar of strength. As Yuna Leska had her Lord Zaon.
I don't know what that means.
Lady Yuna, until next we meet.
Somebody else.
Farewell.
Has Yuna's name, Yuna Leska? I wonder if that's who she's named after. Seymour is definitely an interesting character. Like, just when I start to, was starting to warm up to him, and then he was kind of creepy. Or, I guess creepy isn't quite the right word, but not properly. His emotional reaction to things was not what I would sympathize with. See, I don't really fully understand who or what the Maesters are yet. I mean, I know obviously they're like the four religious leaders of the community. Yeah, well, he starts seeming like, you're like, oh, okay, his heart's in the right place. We're doing this together. He understands. He's compassionate. And he says it just something, and you're just like, something's not right with that boy. So I don't know. I don't know if that was flirtation. It does sound kind of like he was saying that. Yeah, but Shibima, what I'm curious about is they can summon, but they're not summoners. They don't go on the summoner pilgrimage. So does that mean that the dude that Oran doesn't trust, which, interestingly, it turns out that even though I don't like Oran, it turns out I trust him. I didn't realize that until last time when the portly bishop dude, Maester, was like, hey, what's up, Oran? And Oran is like, I do not trust you. And I was like, oh, I don't trust him either then, which is interesting for me because I didn't realize my own feelings until they expressed themselves. So, there you go. Those of you who want me to like him, I trust him. So that's the first step. Let's see if I can do so that I'm not gonna break up. Defeated by cups. It's Lauren. So, I'm going to start off and tell you guys. Well, I don't like him, but apparently I'm convinced he's on my side. Or at least that he can tell who's not to be trusted. I suspect he's got his own agenda, and I certainly don't like him or his attitude or the way he treats people, but I'm going to okay, first of all, ruining the moment. Is it just me? Or does that look like a hot dog floating in the water over there? A, like, not fully cooked hot dog. Just waiting to be finished, cooked, popped on a bun with some ketchup and mustard and dill relish, because if you eat any kind of relish that isn't dill, I don't understand you. I can add that quote if you want, CV. Hang on. There we go. Oh my god, sweet relish, are you people for real? Do you eat half sour pickles? Hold up. Pickles are a very serious thing, okay? So my dad's side of the family are New York Jews and we take our deli and our pickles very seriously. And my family, dill is the way to go. So I have very strong feelings about dill pickles. No half sours for me, no bread and butter. I don't care what you call them. They're not dill, they're not for me. Anyway, yes. Titus contemplates a hot dog. Still life. Oh, man. Anyway. I realize that that is extremely tonally inappropriate for this point of the game, and I apologize for ruining immersion. But if you'll bear with me, I have some speculation that I think is in order that doesn't have anything to do with hot dogs or miniature golf. But if we tried really hard, we might be able to. I bet we could make it work with mini golf if we really wanted to. Hi, Ormy. All right. So my speculation in this, which has some overlap with some of the stuff going on in my novel. So maybe that's why my brain jumped in this direction. I don't know for sure. That's a good question. Maybe you shouldn't be evil. If you're evil, you should stop and reconsider your ways. but okay, so it's quite clear that the people of Spira are powerless. Frankly, powerless against sin, which just shows up and wrecks everybody's day, just constantly. So you can't really fully build anything. You're constantly in a state of rebuilding. And so people try really hard to do the best they can, but there's a certain degree of desperation at this point. Like, it feels like they're hanging by a thread with their hope. So they look to the teachings of Yevon, and the teachings of Yevon are kind of unclear about what sin is, which is weird. So there's kind of sin is punishment for us having dealt with, having used machina, which we're not supposed to use. And so sin is here to punish us for what our ancestors did. It's kind of a poor choice of punishment if we don't know what we're in trouble for, and we're not even necessarily on the same page about whether we're being punished or not. Like, that to me seems like something is up there. But I don't know. You look at the situation at hand, and people turn to Yevon for hope, and they turn to Blitzball for hope. And, like, it's weird because, like, the Blitzball, like, Blitzball Yevon overlaps as far as, like, the, like, prayer thing is interesting and weird, and something's up. Anyway, maybe it's because of fiction and things like that, but I'm inherently distrustful of religious, like, organizations in any work of fiction. Generally speaking, largely they're not to be trusted. The fact that we have now met three maesters. One of them is an old dude. One of them is a guy Auron doesn't trust. And one of them is Seymour, who just kind of doesn't quite seem right. And then you look at this was just like this moment of hope that they allow the hope to happen and then be destroyed. my speculation here, and I'm sorry for like the long-winded kind of messy setup. Maybe instead of backing things up and setting things up, maybe I should just like put down on a platter like, this is what I think is going on. But that's not how I am. I'm a really circular talker, and you need to hear all the background of things. Anyway, my fear is that the Yevon organization is in some way in control of sin, and I don't know how closely they control sin or not, but that they're doing it to keep the people in line, to maintain power for themselves, maybe to keep people, maybe if we're thinking as benevolently as we possibly can, perhaps they think that if they keep people in line, then more bad things won't happen. And so, regardless of whether they're doing it solely for their own personal power and benefit and control, or if they think that they know what's best for the people and this is what's best for the people, whatever the reason is, I think that they are in some way responsible for keeping the cycle going. So to build on our mini golf theory, I guess it would Well, no, that doesn't make any sense. How does sin fit into mini golf? Is sin like the... You know, no. I don't know that I have it in me to make this mini golf. But it would be kind of like if it was like raining. If there was something about like the situation. You know, okay, no, not the windmill. No, okay, so there's the bottomless hole. CB, you must not have caught a couple of streams ago. I had this big long thing about how it's a mini golf. It like took me like 15 minutes or something to explain. I don't know. But okay, so if the final summoning is the bottomless final thing in your mini golf course, maybe it's supposed to be a normal course. Maybe you're supposed to then get your ball and keep moving, and you can't do it. But maybe Yevon is the mini golf course developer that put that hole in there. And maybe it's supposed to be stacked up to the bottom, but they're the one to take it out. I don't know. But I feel like if sin is the thing we're trying to stop, but we're not actually trying to stop because the people in charge are also the people making the bad thing happen. It's okay, short. I'm speculating what's going on. What it comes down to is that I think that the good guys are in charge of the bad guys. So I'm really completely failing. I'll think on it and see if I can mini golf it up. Well, I'm glad to know, Lux, because that's basically what I've got. So I'm going to kind of be looking at this from the perspective of somebody who absolutely does not trust the religious organization, which will be really harsh for poor Yuna here, because faith is clearly part of her. This is my first time playing Final Fantasy X. Because Yuna's faith is part of what sustains her. And in a way, faith is what sustains the people, but at the same time, it kind of holds them back. I don't know. I really like the idea that, like, or rather not like, oh yes, that's awesome, and I'm super glad that's the case, but I am in agreement with, I'm in agreement with Oron's judgment of the situation at hand, that they allowed this to happen to demonstrate what happens if you break the rules. So that you are like, oh crap, I better follow the rules then, because people are clearly... Well, because people are clearly getting, like the people of Spira are restless. You would think that having had a calm, they would be kind of chill, relatively speaking, about the whole thing. Like, okay, the cycle is all right. But they're, like, at the breaking point. There are, like, several people I've spoken to who are like, I'm going to go anywhere in the world to try to get away from sin. There are people who are really getting into Machina because they're like, we need something. Enough so that the Crusaders and the Albed, who as far as I can tell do not have a lot of love for each other, are teaming up to try to stop sin. And this crazy last-ditch desperate thing, they are willing to basically sell their souls to the devil to save their families. Like, that is how desperate they are. Oh, thanks, Ormi. Yeah. I don't like him, but I'm finding that I trust his distrust of other people. So that's a step. But while Fluffy, yeah, sorry, the mini golf perspective's the thing I started and we're stuck with it now. But I was going somewhere. Where was I going? Oh, yeah. It feels like the people are hitting a breaking point. They're really desperate to, they're really desperate for a change. And so I kind of wonder whether everything that is going on now is to try to crush them back into obedience. In which case, how does Tidus fit into this? And has Sin in the past been a person, or is it new that Sin is my dad? Like, was Sin someone else's dad? Has Sin been this, like, never-ending line of people's dads going back thousands of years? Like, I don't know, man. So we'll find out, I suppose. There's gotta be something significant going on with the dads. You know? Wild Fluffy appeared. Thank you for following. Yes. I don't know. And like, maybe Sin inherently gendered. Maybe it's moms or I don't know. I don't know. But Tidus is probably going to have to deal with the burden of knowing that his dad just destroyed everything and keeps destroying everything and making his girlfriend sad. Excuse me, not his girlfriend. They're not dating. Jeez, Dad. Maybe Jack is just disapproving of his son finding happiness. Yeah, basically, Careless Dragon. Okay, so if you go to the original, there's Tzahaha Hanerkind. If you go to that video and you look in the comments, you'll find me like repeatedly replying to my own comment over a period of years because I love that track so much. But I actually really legitimately like the laugh scene. I think it's fantastic. I think it's well acted and well written and well characterized, and it's intentionally awful where it's awful. See, but Wild Fluffy, there is the thing that I like so much about Tidus. Is that I could totally see Jekt being like, you could never destroy a town as well as me. And I could see Tidus being like, I don't even want to try because that's the wrong thing to do, so screw you, Dad. So he would back away from that competition. That would be, I mean, obviously, cause, you know? Like, yeah. 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 Anyway. Dadness. I want to talk to my friends. I want to talk to all of my friends before progressing the story. Talk to my girlfriend first. Did I get the right button?
Maesters are strict.
She's trying to laugh. See, that is good characterization right there. They set that up. They set that up well so you know exactly what's going on. Like, that is a very nicely, like, good. Good. I approve. Because that shows us how incredibly devastated she is right now. That's so fantastic. There's good writing in this game. Jekt is a pretty good example of don't be like me. Oh, jeez. Don't rub it in, Waka. Don't you dare rub it in.
You can't ignore the teachings. You can't ignore the teachings.
See, CB, that sounds completely out of character for him. I think that as much as he wants to prove something to his dad, I also think that he actually has a strong sense of right and wrong. Oh gosh, are you guys ready for like horrible, sad descriptions of people being dead? No, just their souls here. Gosh. Okay, one of these days in this game, there's going to be massive destruction and we're not going to be able to save the souls and they're going to all turn into monsters and they're going to be monsters that are the souls of our friends and it's going to be awful. I'm going to be really mad. Just so you know, if that happens, I'm not going to be happy. Oh, jeez. Okay, Kimari. Come on, blue guy. I've started using you in combat. I'm leveling you up. I'm saying nice things to you. Come on. Come on, seriously. I love that the height difference. Well, no, but unit performs ascending, and then it doesn't happen. Okay, so he's not gonna shove me. Well, that's good. That would be less appropriate than my hot dog comment for the tone of the game. I cannot find my way around. Well, it's funny because like the height difference between him and me is like pretty substantial. The height difference between me and now Lulu's I thought she was taller. I guess she gives the impression of being taller. Okay, we'll get into the treasure chest. High potion is going to be the difference between me and sudden death. Just so you can see.
Rest while you can. We leave soon. Rest while you can. We leave soon.
All right, I'm sorry. All right, buddy.
Sin is checked.
Yes, you told me.
Yeah. For a while there, I thought I could feel him. But that doesn't mean I believe you.
About which part?
Sin is checked. He came here for you.
So he killed all those people just for a chance to see me?
That's what Sin does. He wanted to show that to you. Do you know why?
Because I'm supposed to turn into
him. How am I supposed to know?
So you would kill him. As long as he is Sin, Jekt will keep killing. He wants you to stop him.
Wait, hold
up. You gotta be kidding. How do you know all of this anyway?
Don't fucking... Don't laugh at me, Auron!
I'm not done talking to you. Don't you run away!
You're the one running.
Alright, so let it be established that I am still as annoyed by Auron as I ever was. It's part of why I like Tidus. It's because when he gets mad at things, I'm also getting mad at things. No, Chrono, it's happened a couple of times. You just watched my cats. No, I have to be careful saying that, Emily, or you're going to start trying to get me to swear more so that you can just have cats stream all the time. Here, this is for you. There's Ella. And Nox is being a lump in the cat tree. Yes, Auron makes me really mad. Hi, Ludicrous Limes, welcome back. The cat tree is actually quite successful and quite popular. Okay, no, there's something I'm thinking of. What was it? Where somebody is like trying to get, oh gosh, this something about this setup is familiar. I guess I'm relieved the answer to that is not because you will become him. I'm glad to know that it's that it, I don't know. So if Jekt wants me to kill him, does that mean that the proper answer? I just realized what that made me think of. Another tragic video game dad, except one that I actually really like. But I don't want to spoil that game because I like it a lot. I get the impression that he doesn't really have much control over himself. It seems like he kind of gets to pick where he goes and then just like destruction happens. He like constantly gives off a death aura. So he kind of like whoom, 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 when everything dies and whoom, 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 whoom. It could happen, Balorn, is all I'm saying. That would not be out of character. Oh no! Well, I'm glad you're not dead.
Are you all right? Thank you. I will.
I don't think I need healing. Do I need healing? Am I dying? No, I'm not dying. Hello, friends. Oh, you're not dead. That's good. I'm glad you're not dead. But again, like, if you were going to manipulate people, this is a great way of making sure they go home and let everybody know that Sin is terrifying. You!
Arn made a bundle with the operation prices. Why you turned out. They deserved a better deal.
That is probably about as much conscience as we'll get from him.
I guess the summoners are our only hope.
That's the goal of the guys in charge, isn't it? Isn't it? Isn't it? Hi, everybody.
Hey, you two. Hurry up.
She's trying so hard.
She's awfully cheerful.
Tidus, come on! You just talked to her about this, like, yesterday.
In dark times, she must be. She must shine bright.
Huh?
Now are dark times. Yuna tries hard.
We should help her then.
If we worry, she tries harder. Do not frown.
Interesting. I believe those are...
Don't worry, be happy.
Kimari, try too.
Smile, let me see.
Oh, God.
Sad.
Oh, no, Tidus, he's trying so hard. Okay, that was really cute, though. I believe that's literally the first time that we ever heard Kimari's voice. Like, I didn't realize that he had an accent. Yes, there's comic relief. Reasonably well handled. Oh, new enemies. Oh no, I'm poisoned! Hold on. Baka! It's flying, so you're gonna hit it. Vulnerable to ice, huh? Well, fortunately for you, I have... What weapon do I have equipped? What weapon do I have equipped? Okay, so poison is kind of bad. Oh man, Nautilus has big feelings about the fact that they're attacking Kimari for his smile. Poor Kimari. Alright, so let's get Yuna out here and cure our buddy. Oh, I didn't realize there was a mushroom. I didn't see the mushroom. Sorry, buddy. Wait, no, 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 not summon. White magic. Isuna on... No, not the bad guy! The good guy. Yeah, but like... Yuna did not do ascending out there. Did I do it wrong? Oop. That's no good. Now I'm gonna get set on fire. Truly... the worst... judgment call. For our terrible actions is being set on fire. Alright. Lulu? You're gonna use fire on the thing that uses fire for some reason? Bite bug! Oh wait, is it the order list on the right? Okay, that explains why I'm always confused.
It's over.
Cause I'm like, is it ups or is it lefts and rights? Like, I don't know. Aw, look at you, Auron, you don't get anything. You weren't in that battle at all because you tried to walk coolly and awesomely away. Well, I won't have any of it. Hi friends! Friend! Talk to me! Oh yeah, I definitely want to equip that. Holy crap! Are you serious? No, 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 no. Hold on. Okay, hold on. Wrong button! He's not still frozen, is he? Somebody's gonna have to equip that thing. Who does that? Oh, is it? Hold up. What did he give me now? Oh, would you give me a soft? I guess you want to give it to your healer? Does she equip it? Her ring is, I think, pretty good. But stone proof. Yeah, okay. Alright. Oh, you're looking all brooding and sad. Does that wipe out the entirety of the Crusaders? Like, were all of the Crusaders involved in this and now they're gone? Is this another effort of control? Like, to just get rid of another branch? Because people have been joining the Crusaders. Okay. Waka, you're gonna throw at one of these guys. Yeah, bam! Kamari, you're gonna try to hit one of these guys? And you're gonna set it on fire. Yeah, well, the thing is that my question is, is it the Crusaders in that operation, or is it all of the Crusaders in the entire world? Well, the world of Spira that we know of. Oh, hello! Wait! Don't! Where are you going? Not talking to me is where they're going, I think. No, not you. Titas, I think one of these is for you. Why? Bunny Yip. I think these guys are fast. No. I clearly need to. I'm never gonna get this right. Yeah, well, I think that seems to be the idea of Oddington. That's what I'm suspecting is the case. Okay, so that needs piercing. Got it. Yeah. We'll let Oron come in and take a turn because he missed last time. I'm still mad at you, buddy. Experience. You never want your healer to run out. Was that everybody? Did everybody get a turn? Oh, except Waka. Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. Hello. I'm sorry, buddy, but your buddy is probably doing just fine, and I'm sure you'll come across him soon. Whoop. All right. Waka, you're gonna attack the one that's in the air. Watch out for something. Ugh. Piercing. Nimble. Sorry, I'm like, I really can't figure out. They really should be consistent. Is Tina's not?
Farewell.
You're so dramatic, Oron. So dramatic. Man, maybe I should level up my people a bit. I bet that would help. Ah, wrong button! Buttons. Alright, Kamari, what was I doing with Kamari? Was I going this way, health, extract mana. And then this is gonna take him to Lulu. Yes, that's what I was gonna do. This one takes him over to, hold up. Lock no. Move. Here. So use a power sphere. Use another power sphere. Look at how powerful. Then we're gonna move here. And then we're gonna use an ability sphere. I guess we're gonna have to get more of those. Oron, you're gonna move here. And then we're gonna use power sphere. We're gonna use mana sphere. Then we're gonna move here. and then we're gonna use... Wait, what am I on? Oh, I already used it. Never mind. Hold on, I have to figure out what I'm doing. Oh, it looks like I'm going this way. Okay. Let's move here. Right? I came from there, and now I want to go there. Yes. Move here. Use a power sphere. Yeah! My strength is starting to overflow! Okay, so this is a big bad lock. So we're gonna go in here and get some more HPs and accuracies and things. Mostly lots of HPs. Nice. Yuna, you're gonna move here. Oops, you're gonna use mana sphere. Mana defense. Magic. What? Sorry, I'm not trying to ignore you guys. Trying to figure out what to do here. Haha! I'm gonna use all the ability spheres. Thundara! Blizzara! Watera! I think that's all of them. Nice. HP, defense, magic defense, and evasion. So that looks like that's like a little detour. But I'm gonna take it. Auron is edgy because of his piercing sword. Okay. That is pretty great. Use an ability sphere, sleep attack. That sounds useful. Use mana sphere. Max MP is up. Alright, I used all the points on all the everybody. Seymour has a last name, doesn't he? Oh. Sorry, I got completely distracted. Oh jeez, they do a really good job of animating, like... Oh jeez, yep, I think Auron was right. Some things are not worth it. Fighting two basilisk things is one of those. Those things came in, speaking of drama, those things came in all dramatically. Alright, Waka. You ready to smack into the face of the ball? Bam! Kimari, I believe you've got a freeze weapon too. No! I'm never gonna get that right. Alright, and then you're gonna get replaced with Lulu. Who is gonna use black magic? She's gonna cast a spell on you. So nobody has last names. Okay, excellent.
Hey! How much longer till Xanarkand?
Titus.
Still a ways.
First down the moonflow to the Guado city of Guadosalam.
Oh, he wants us to be over.
Then we cross
Guido's
the thunder plains to the temple of Makalania.
Oh, boy.
And before that, we get to pray at the temple in Djose.
We can't just skip all that, can we, huh?
Mm-mm. I have to pray to the faith in every temple in order to earn the final Aeon.
That's a summoner's training. She's got to prepare mind and body, all just to get ready for the final summoning.
That sounds like a bad thing.
Must be tough, Yuna.
I'll be fine with you here.
She's flirting with you, Titus. I know you're really bad at noticing, but she is. Definitely. Without question. Oh, good. I can talk to people. Oh, is it trying to force my hand, huh? Acting.
Hey, new guy.
Me?
Who else?
Wait, no, but
what can I do for you, boss?
Don't tell Yuna you know about Sin and Jekt.
Huh?
You know her. She would distance herself from you. We do not want that.
Oren, what is your problem?
I think. Yeah, but even if I did say something, no one believed me, you know?
Yuna would.
Ah, you have a point. Come to think of it, did I really have to know about Jekt? What about my feelings?
Better than you finding out at a critical moment, becoming emotional.
What? Me? Emotional?
I heard you were quite the crybaby.
Yeah, maybe when I was a kid. Maybe even a little now. Just a little. Hey, I still don't buy your story, you hear?
Oh, Titus. I'm sorry, buddy. Oh, there's like little critter thingies. What are those little critters? Oh, geez, what?
Whoa.
Hold up. What was that? What was that? Not good. I mean, nobody else seems upset.
Yuna, it is good to see you and your companions are well.
Yourselves as well, Captain. We were worried.
Glad she's alive.
Praise be to Yevon.
We escaped with our lives, but our troops were decimated.
Little jumpy guys.
Of all our chocobos, only this one made it.
We make pretty poor chocobo-mounted forces without chocobos.
We turned our backs on the teachings and cast away our faith. This is our just reward. Just you know, but don't worry, we're here for you.
We should never have ignored the teachings.
What are these little jumpy guys?
Is that the Djose Temple?
So this must be elemental. This must be where I got Titan. Titan is the earth elemental. No, it looks like lightning. So is this Ramu?
Awesome.
Huh. The lightning mushroom rock. It only opens when a summoner is addressing the faith.
That means another summoner's already in there.
Oh, it's gonna be that jerk lady.
Another summoner?
What if it's Donna?
I'm sure it is.
We have to hurry.
Right! In we go!
Those little monkey guys. Hello, monkey guys! Are we friends? I hope, by the way, is somebody ready to walk me through the temple? Because there's a temple. And this is the only time that I go with, like, a straight-out, blatant, no-holds-barred, I-don't-want-to-do-the-thing. Oh. Something's green and glowing. What is this? What's green and glowing? What are you doing, green and glowy thing? Oh, I can go inside. Well, hello, friend. Okay, that's legit. Hey, Stolen Light, well, you mostly missed me letting the world know that I actually think that the bad guys are being controlled by...
The monks said we could stay here for a while. This little fella's finally calmed down.
Oh my gosh, the little jumpy guys!
I've been thinking about the future. No matter what we do next, We're going to do it for Yevon, that's for sure. No matter what we're going to do it for you.
I would pray for those fallen in battle. But how? How can I enter the temple after what we have done? The monks of Djose have kindly offered to heal our wounded. Yevon still looks out for us. Even now.
Yeah, Yevon is clearly behind this, and that's really uncool. Is this a person?
Luzu, he's...
Oh, jeez.
Where is he?
I found him. He was torn in half.
Oh, my goodness! Okay, I thought I just, like...
Idiot!
What do I do now? I can't do this. I'm going back to Besaid.
Could have been you, kid. I think we're all glad that it wasn't, except maybe you.
Luzu, he's...
Somebody needs to be taking care of this child, but I guess they're busy with people who are actually physically dying. Alright, well, whoever was the mastermind behind that destruction, I hope you're happy. I don't actually want you to be happy. I don't want you to do this again.
I beg your pardon, but may I ask your name?
Who is this?
I am Summoner Yuna, from the Isle of Besaid.
As I thought. The daughter of Lord Braska. You have the look of your father.
You are really overdressed, mister.
My father? You knew him?
No. I have never met the man.
Why did he just step up?
Ah, my apologies. I am Isaru.
Kimari doesn't trust
him. I am a summoner, like you.
I'm Bussy. Pleased to meet you.
Oh my god, is one of his guardians a
and
child?
And I'm Moroda.
Like a literal
I'm
child?
I'm guarding my big brother here.
Oh
Since
my god, they can't
child,
die!
I've always
they can't die!
Looked up to Lord Braska.
You can't kill them, game! You can't do
I
it!
I wished I would someday become a high summoner like he was. You must have some of your father's talent in you. I believe you might someday defeat Sin.
I'm not really. I've only just become a summoner.
Of course, I've no intention of losing either. So perhaps we should race to see who can defeat Sin first, no?
Oh, very well then. I accept your challenge.
Isaru!
Yuna, I beg your leave. Good luck to both of us.
Yes.
They're gonna kill him and his brothers, and I'm gonna be really mad. Square, I have my eye on you. I see what you're doing, and I'm not okay with it. It's funny, though, like, when I knew there was another summoner here, like, I was already, like, wincing inside, you know, like, expecting it to be, Donna.
Oh, it's so pretty.
And then they, like, completely disarm me.
Oh, it's so pretty.
By having it be this really nice guy and his two, presumably two brothers. Is this where I'm supposed to go? Nope. Somebody's being a blitzball. Hello, child. Oh! Shalinda, are you being chased around by children? What are you doing? No, get back here! Oh, maybe it's not Shalinda. No, you have value. No, Titus, don't lick the electricity. That's a bad idea. No, go through the door and talk to the person. Oh no, you lost your companion. Oh dear. Somebody didn't make it. Maybe there are more people in there. Is the captain around? No, okay. Wait. Nope, that appears to be somebody either dead or sleeping on the bed. Things are not good here. Spira is not a good place to be. Yes, I know we want the treasure, but that'll be once we start the thing. I will give you my potions. I have some. I can give you that. I just opened it up and got it out of your chest. I can give it back to you. Lord Meehan, found of the Crusaders. Yes, probably seeing all of his people dead would be not cool. Oh, there's a treasure in the last room too? This is not good. This is not good, friends. Wait, I know the captain. I spoke to the captain. I feel bad taking things from their treasure chests, but it's not actually gonna... Oh, there it is. It's not gonna change the story. That one actually might be useful. Just in case Yuna is for some reason unavailable.
Hey, you.
Ah.
Me?
You are Yuna's guardian, no?
What are you doing?
Moroda's heard a curious rumor. I thought you should know.
Oh dear, do I not trust you
either? I heard it from those Crusaders. Seems that summoners have been going out on pilgrimage and just disappearing.
It could just be the fiends got them, but not so many so quickly.
Huh.
Sorry I don't know more, but watch your back. Ain't much future for a guardian without a summoner, eh?
What? What y'all talking about?
We're talking about doing your job as a guardian.
Hey, I'm doing good. Right, big brother?
Just in case you missed it. This is not good.
Please be careful.
No, you be careful,
will
please.
Will do.
You and your brothers are adorable.
Passe!
Oh, what?
We're leaving!
Be right there! See ya!
This is not gonna end well. It's a lot of characterization right there.
The cloister of trials lies with.
I guess I should probably save. And then we're gonna go, and you guys are gonna help me figure out where the explodey bits are, right? There's the save. Save sphere. So does that mean there's somebody else in there because the thing's all going like wobbly whoop? Look at that, they said it's only when somebody's talking to the Faith. And Isaru just left. So. Yes, it's certainly not that they're gonna just kill all the characters. They're gonna kill all the characters.
The cloister of trials lies within. Are you prepared?
So for those of you who don't usually watch my game streams, I generally have a no-spoiler, no-backseating policy, but these cloisters are garbage, so I take a walkthrough. So I guess the Faith is still feeling conversational now that Isaru is gone, but they're still, because the rocks are crashing around outside with lightning. So let's do this, my friends. Let us go blow up the blowy up bits.
All right,
and get through
guardians,
this as quickly
at attention.
Possible.
We are ready.
Oh, Waka, are you big
right.
brother guardian?
Let's do it.
He's captain, team captain. Oh God, even this song just makes me really unhappy. All right, is anybody ready? Can anybody tell me which one of these things I should grab? Or should I go get the book that Greg gave me? I'm scared to look. Okay, put both spheres in the door. Okay, thank you, Emily. Djose's sphere. Okay. door. Okay, well, if Emily's willing to do it, she's one of the reasons why I'm playing the game, so. Hi, Omega Zero! I was actually going to say that this sounds like a not good track from Final Fantasy VII, but I don't want to hurt Nautilus's feelings, because he likes that game. Okay, in the next room, take the two spheres and put them in the right. That's this hand. This thing is not mirrored, much to my dismay. Okay, so next room. Yeah, I know, I appreciate that, Emily, although I'll stop when I get to a new room, but it is good to know. Okay. I do have kitty ears. Wait, it looks like there's three spheres. Wait, there's a whole bunch of spheres! Emily, what do I do? There's like one, two, three, four spheres, or am I wrong? Does it matter which spheres I take? Okay, I need two. Alright. So you said the right wall. Is this the right wall? Or is the right wall out here? 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 We're back there. I'm sorry, guys. I'm really not good at following directions. I'm gonna just stay here until it is confirmed which direction to go. Right where you took the sphere. Okay. Where all the spheres are, so you go to the right. Here? Is this right? Oh, there's a glyph on the wall. Okay, got it. Got it. Okay, so then I get the other one, yes? I get this one? Okay. And I go put it next to that. Nope, nope, you leave it alone, Titus. I didn't tell you to push it, so I put it here. Alright, yes. Titus only has one hand. Yes. I think that's right. No, that's not right. No? I'm really... This, by the way, my friends, this is why. Because even with a walkthrough, I can still not... What? Look at that! It's all sparkly. Do not stand under that. You're going to get electrocuted. Did I get it? Okay. Push pedestal under the glowy thing. Okay. Like that? Ah! It's getting electrocuted! Yes, this is my first playthrough. Okay, now I seem to have made a super thing. What do I do with it now? We're doing this. Take extra glowy sphere. Put it to the right of the door. Here? This is the right of the door, right? Our right. Electrocute. Indeed. Speaking of cute. Look at Ella. Look at what a flop she is. She's all flump. Who's a Belle? You're a Belle. Oh my gosh, I love you, Bella Belle. She's a good kitty. Okay, now take two spheres of the wall and then both of the pedestal. Oh, the ones that are on the wall. These, yes. Put it in the pedestal. Do I have to push the pedestal? They are really good cats. I like them a lot. I assume I'm moving this? Or what else do I do? Push pedestal into lightning floor. Oh, hey, you're right. It is totally electrocution city in there. How on earth are you supposed to figure this out without a walkthrough? I don't want to go in there. Holy crap. This seems like a really bad idea. Alright, well, I don't think I want to walk in there. Pretty sure that I get electrocuted. Wait, seriously? Huh? How am I not dead? Okay, so I take this. That's a lot of electricity out there. What did I just do? Wait, no, did I do that wrong? Is that what I was supposed to do? I'm sorry, that was my only option. Okay, so that was all right. Okay, good. Okay. Okay. We're good. All right, now what do I do? Hop back and do a bunny dance. I can't jump in this game or I would be jumping right now. You can be sure of that. Go to the left side. Step on the floor glyph. Oh, to the left side, there's a floor glyph. Ah, I see. Okay, I stepped on the floor glyph. Oh, and now I've got this back. Now what do I do with this guy? In Chrono, I've managed to screw up. I broke a cloister. I don't remember which one I broke. It might even have been the first. No, it can't have been the first one. Maybe it was. No, I think it was. Yes. No. I don't think I've seen... I don't think that I've... Okay, put them back in the very, very first slots. So those are here? Where did the other one... Where did the other one go? To the other side of the door? Goes left the door. So do I take that other one out? This was in the wrong place. Where does it go? I don't remember. You cannot count on me to remember a thing. Oh, the very first room. Okay. Thank you. Yes. Unfortunately. And the extra glowy one? I'm really confused. Oh, I think I can safely say that we've actually passed where I was in the game. I think, before. I don't remember. I actually legitimately don't remember. Okay, so this one goes to the very beginning and then take the extra glowy one? Oh, extra glowy one goes to the front. Oh, okay. So this goes back here. Okay. I get it. At least I don't remember anything about Operation Mihan. Oh, that door just closed. Well, that sucks for me. The whole symbol needs to be lit. Okay, well, is it here? Yes. That's kind of a cool looking symbol. I can't tell what it is. It's kind of like an eyeball, but also an owl. An eye owl? Eye owl? Okay, this next part sucks. Alright, then I'm counting on you, my friends. You're gonna have to tell us what to do. Why are things like this in the game? Why do games have puzzles like this? Get on the pedestal. Get on the pedestal? Oh, wait, I have to summon the pedestal, right? I go over here and I press the thing, right? Right? Wait. Stuff on. Oh, that's a pedestal! Okay. Oh, that's the Yevon symbol. Okay. I'll have to figure that out. Okay. I'm sorry, guys. I did it right, yes? So now I go in here, and this is a pain. Push all the pedestals back into the wall. Oh, I see, okay. Alright, it's gonna take a moment then. So I don't have to... Do I have to press a button? Oh, okay, I do. Okay, I do. Got it. Once you're done with it, stay. All right. I stay. I'm here. I'm staying put. I'm being a good Lauren. What do I do now? It's more electricity, but at least it's not fire. We already did the fire once, so I don't have to deal with fire anymore. Yay, no more fire ever in any video game. Okay, go back down. This way? How on earth would you figure this out on your own? Don't get on the floor glyph. Wait, here? Do I step in the middle of this thing? Do I step in it? I step on this. Right? Yes? Get down where you came up. Okay. Got it. Don't get on the floor glyph, but touch the wall glyph on the left. Oh, okay. Oh, this right here. Okay. So touch this. So I touch this. Yes? Yeah, it does seem like you would have to have a strategy guide. It's so obtuse and dumb. Like, how would you even know there was a thing here? Oh, this opens up the destruction sphere! Yes! Okay. Alright, I'm gonna go blow something up! Alright, tell me, my friends, where do I blow the things up? No, up is this way. Don't drop it, Titus, or we're all gonna get blown up. Nobody wants that. Okay. I have a destruction sphere. I'm up. Stairs. Now what do I do? Push all pedestals back in. Push them back in? Like, pull them in? There are five? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I only saw the three. This game. Got it. What? Don't step into that, Titus. I think that's a bad idea. What just happened? Okay, so did I go up the stairs? Okay, the pedestal is up. Put this destruction sphere in the pedestal. So I want to insert the destruction sphere here. Don't lick it, Titus. Not going up the stairs. Sphere in here. Yes, this is where it goes. Right there. Yes. Good. Thank you, guys. I imagine this is really annoying. But it's got to be done. All right. Blow up the wall. Boom. there goes the wall. Hey, look, it's a treasure chest. Let me get that before anything else happens. Magic sphere? Is that special? Okay, so now I can go up the stairs, right? We're okay with the stairs, yes? Yes? All right. We're gonna moonwalk a little bit. All right, then we're gonna stop moonwalking and we're gonna go up the stairs. Oh man, this game. It's good, but those cloister things.
Stop pacing around, be calm and wait.
Like you're one to talk.
Stop pacing around, be calm and wait.
Erg! I'll show you what I think of that.
Well, well, you again.
Oh, jeez.
Still traveling, quite the crowd, I see.
Oh, jeez, Donna.
What is it, Bartello? You know this riffraff?
You are... Aren't, no?
What of it?
Can I shake your hand? Aren.
He's a
no. Sir Aren.
Oh my god.
You're the reason I became a guardian.
Oh my god, he's a fanboy! Will you do it? Oh my god, he's doing it! Oh my god! I don't know what to make of
Thank
that.
Thank you, sir. This means so much to me.
Oh my god, actually, that's really adorable.
Calling the personal guardian to Lord Braska Riffraff?
Ha! Ha! Ha!
And you call yourself a summoner?
Yeesh.
Bartello, enough! Get back here.
He's... Hang in there, buddy. Eh?
Feels bad for him for having to deal with her. I like that everyone like has this like moment of like, because Lulu delivered an excellent burn. Donna might want some ice for that. Probably not Omega Zero. Go talk to them. Where are they? Are they through the door? Oh wait, no, they're here. Okay.
I swear, I'll never wash this hand again.
Please touch me with that hand, and I'll remove it.
Uh-oh.
How much longer? She sure is taking her sweet time. We've got places to go. We can't be kept waiting like this.
You can, and you will.
I met Sir Aren. The Sir Aren.
That's really cute. I'm sorry. That's really adorable. And the fact that Aren doesn't, like, give him an attitude is nice. Hi, Waka.
Quite the show, yeah? Not so good on the heart, though.
Oh.
Not all summoners are like Yuna, I guess.
Yep. It's okay, Zyru was pretty cool.
Not all summoners.
You should try to settle down. Yuna will be blamed if anything happens. Now we wait. This is also a guardian's duty.
Alright. Alright, blue guy. We hit a moment.
Pick spot. Shut up. Wait. You grow stronger, but are still a pup. You grow strong.
His voice has a very strange texture to it. So I pick a spot and I wait. What if I pick this spot? Does this light offset my hair just right? I love that Tina bleaches his hair.
Now we wait.
Stop pacing around. Be calm and wait.
Shall we pace around or shall we wait, friends? You're in front of the door she went through. Kamari, what makes you number one guardian? I guess we'll find out. This is the spot that I'm pacing in, I suppose. So they never... Okay, well, they haven't. Maybe they
you
will.
You owe much to your father.
Shut up, Donna.
All these guardians. And Sir Auron, too? And I hear Maester Seymour is quite taken with you. The world must look different when you're the daughter of Lord Braska.
This has nothing to do with my father. I'm traveling on my own, as a full-fledged summoner.
Oh, is that so? Then try standing
doing?
On your own two legs
wait, wait.
For
hey,
once.
No, what is Tidus? Guys, no, did you see Tidus is like boogieing
your
in the background.
Your guardians won't be able to protect you when the time comes.
Did you see him dancing? He was like going like this. He was like... Like he totally was. Like I'm not the only one who saw that. He was totally dancing in the background there. I don't know why he was doing that. It didn't look like he was getting ready to fight. It looked like he was like bored and doing like a little weird little dance routine. Now I'm gonna like check and see if he does that again. Ixion looks like a goat with a beard. All right. He's adorable. I like him.
No matter how dark the night, morning always comes.
Yes.
And our journey begins anew.
Very nice, Greg.
No matter how dark the night, morning always comes.
There was.
And our journey begins anew.
A quote I really liked when I was younger. Something like even in the darkest, something hope springs eternal. I don't know.
We're leaving once Yuna gets here.
Let me save, so I don't have to do that ever again. Ever, no, never. Never, never, never. Ever, ever, never. Yeah, Orcris was playing through Terranigma, and he got to the goat, and let everybody know that goat has a root in common with tragedy, I believe. Which, if you played Terranigma, I understand where that came from. Hi, Kamari.
Donna has left. Isaru, too. Donna.
We're leaving once Yuna gets...
So are those the same guy? Is that what you're saying? Those two are the same person? Voice actor? Interesting.
Get ready for the journey ahead.
They're like, hey, by the way, this is going to be a hard section, so make sure you've got all the stuff you need. I opened the treasure chest already. I like that there's no music here, just sound effects. Aha! Look at that. I found... Ooh! That's very, very nice of them. Like, hey, congratulations. Thank you for exploring.
We're leaving once Yuna gets here.
Oh. All right, so what's she up to now? Is she praying? She only talked to the Faith. There's monkeys on the statue. Hello, monkey friends. You're not tragic. Oh, she's sleeping. I don't know if I can wake her. Is that her?
She was working until dawn, healing the wounded. Sending the fallen.
Okay.
I guess I'll just let her sleep for now, then.
Oh, no.
Ah. Morning.
What? Morning?
Don't worry.
But it's morning. I'm so sorry. I'll get ready right away. Just a moment.
Don't worry. It's okay.
Oh.
Oh. Yo, sleepyhead.
They sped up her walk animation.
Sorry, I'm so sorry.
Aww. Baby.
Please forgive me.
Oh,
really, there's no rush. Here, your hair.
A summoner with bad hair. What's the world coming to?
Oh.
You could have woken me up.
She's so cute. We called to you, but with all that snoring.
Lulu.
What is it today? Everyone's picking on me. Oh, you too, Sir Orin?
Once Lady Yuna fixes her hair, we leave.
I hadn't really laughed like that in a long time. It was only later that I realized. The only one really laughing then was me. Laughing must have been the only thing keeping them going.
Yuna! Yuna, wait! Yuna! I used to apologize like that, but I worked really hard to apologize less. Hold on, there's a dude walking. I need to talk to him. Yeah, they're super making a point here. Oh, there goes the chocobo and friends! Friend! Friend! No!
Off so early? Lady Yuna, you must be exhausted after working so hard last night. Will you be okay?
I feel that I have rested enough, but thank you for your kindness. Will you be leaving too?
Yes. First we cross the moon flow, and then we head north in search of chocobos to replace those we have lost.
Once we find chocobos, our mounted forces will ride again.
Huh? Aren't you missing someone?
Titus.
Captain! Wait for goodness. Me!
Oh my gosh!
What took you so long? We're leaving.
You expect me to keep up with a chocobo?
Lady Yuna, I wish you good fortune.
I see we're
Elma,
getting
Clasco, let's go.
Ma'am.
Hey, can I just rest a sec?
No complaints.
Oh, they're adorable. Yuna! Hello, my friend.
Where to next?
We cross the moonflow.
Oh,
gotcha.
Okay, a river.
Moonflow, baby, here we come.
Huh. Friends. Friends. I don't get to talk to my friends. Oh, there's another person to talk to, though. Hello. Hello, friend. Yeah, somebody wanted to disband the Crusaders. This is a pretty good way to do it.
Good day, everyone.
Oh, dear.
We can all learn a lesson from what has happened to the Crusaders. Only the truly faithful have a hope of defeating sin.
It is Chibi Ma. It is an emote. Goodness. Titus, you're gonna fight the one. Yes, that's right, Titus. Oh, that's right, I have all the things. I think if you just type the words hello, friend, capitalize the first letter and don't put a space between them. I'm not 100% sure, I don't remember, but I think it's Does that work? Yes, it does.
I'm thinking of going to Guado Salam.
I see.
I have not spoken with a Guado for some time. I'm thinking of going. I have not spoken
with. Her voice with a... sounds familiar. From another RPG, I think. Oh my goodness. Burn it with fire? It kind of looks like it's wearing a skirt. Doesn't it?
Go, go, go!
He thinks this is scary. Ah, no, it's immune. Well...
need a light?
Sick burn indeed, Lulu! Nice!
Let's see.
Training, huh?
Training? Hello, mixing metaphors too. All right. Yuna, time to heal.
Summoner Yuna, ready.
Oh my god, she's so cute. Oh, thanks, Mixing Metaphor Soup. I had a lot of fun putting it together. Bam! I should probably equip the rest of my party with fire weapons. Oh no, that's not good. Are they confused?
My turn.
Ice strike. Okay, well. She's poisoned! Let's switch her out for... Tetis? Is this thing like a Marlboro? Does it do random status ailments? Okay, so she has been in everything. I bet I recognize her from... Who was she in Suikoden 5? And who was she until the end of time? Because those are the two ones I most likely recognize. I would have actually guessed till the end of time. So I don't remember Oshu, but I do know Marlboro. I don't know what this says about my memory. Somebody looks really big over here. Tetis, you're gonna fight the thing that you're gonna fight? Oh, Pepita, seriously? She's gotta be some of the side characters too. Was she Lady Nell's sidekick?
know you need someone with magic skills.
Yes, everybody is very impressed with you.
Farewell.
Drama, drama, drama.
That's how it's done.
Uh-huh. Jeez, oh, it's a Ronso. A yellow Ronso. Multiple Ronso.
Look, one of Kimari's friends looks just like him.
What?
Both follow summoners on all fours. Hornless goatlings. Hornless! Hornless!
Actually, this might have been where I left off. Because I remember there being two Ronso who made
you
fun
of
me.
You come to insult Kimari?
Oh, he's itty bitty!
Wrong.
He's
we come
itty-bitty.
To warn little Kimari.
He's such a baby boo!
Summoners disappear. Never return.
Next will be Kimari's summoner.
Poor Kimari! Lost his horn, next lose his summoner. Pitiful Kimari, howl alone,
I don't think the Ronso are very nice. Okay, Kimari, I can kind of see.
Those two got something against you? What, they were just picking on you?
Kimari will deal with them.
And I'll help.
Kimari alone.
But we're friends though, right, buddy?
It's Kimari's problem. You can't interfere. It's a rule.
Oh, Titus is
worried.
Titus is not gonna follow.
Let the Ronso deal with Ronso problems, yeah? That's how it's always been.
I mean, I'm worried about those summoners disappearing.
They aren't just disappearing into thin air.
Hey, if we guardians do our job, no problem, right?
Oh.
Confident.
Yeah.
That's what Titus does. Oh my god, Emily. Oh my god. Okay. That was the perfect response. Yes. Kimari has attended a liberal arts university and received his bachelor's degree. What's his degree in? Ooh, boy. Uh-oh, is there a pun coming? Oh, no! Okay, that was really good. Ooh, man. Okay, that's very clever. See, it's a clever way of getting around swearing. Did you just come up with that on your own? That's very clever. Oh, I should try Yuna's new summon. Let's do that now. Why not?
My turn.
It is your turn. Ixion. I don't even know. Is it a unicorn goat? A lightning unicorn goat? It is a lightning unicorn goat thing! It's horns!
My name's Yuna. Pleased to meet you.
She talks to... She introduces herself to it. Oh my gosh. Okay. Damages an enemy and negates all spell effects. Okay. It is fluffy. and his regal fluffy haunches. Okay, so as everyone reminds me, I can heal myself. Very nice, Valorne. A strange face, I think. Overdrive Thor's hammer! Very dramatic. Does it have a face or a horn instead of a hand? Oh my goodness. Well, that's pretty good. Oh geez, okay. So, summon overdrives take forever. I'm sorry, buddy, but thank you for your service to humanity. Hermes Belmont, thank you for following. I bet you like Castlevania. Pray. Oh no, 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 no. Yeah, no, my bot does a bunch of things. It says hello to people who we follow, and it can give hugs, and... Waka? Omega Zera, thank you for following. Oh wait, not you. You're blinded.
Go, go, go!
That did not work very well. Yeah, so it does quotes. Did I say it does quotes? I'm busy here trying to figure out how to not die. Alright, it died! Those guys are bad news. Ice Moomba! So everybody has ice now, it feels like. That's the one element that I think I've recovered. Oh, right! Sphere Grid! Alright, Kamari. You are my buddy now. What does Jinx do? I may regret this decision, but this is what I'm doing. Use ability sphere, sure. Use speed sphere, yes. Use mana sphere. Probably gonna want that actually. Why is there a lock in the way of these this? Because it's only accessible through here, right? That's weird. Well, we're not doing that. We're gonna move. Speed sphere, evasion. Good. Mana sphere, yes. Should probably. Oh, this is another thing trying to tempt me to use my lock to get. Evasion, agility, HP, strength. But I swear I want to use the lock so that I can use Kamari. Like. I think I've only got the one lock, don't I? What is a magic node versus an MP node? Oh, I've got a bunch of those level one locks. Okay. To have the option of maging. I think I might just have to do level one stuff though and then charge back out on. I don't know, like. I don't know why I've decided that Kamari's gonna be a black mage, but Kamari is gonna be a black mage. Because. Or at least part black mage. Oh goodness. Alright, Waka, you're gonna trade out for, actually wait, don't you have extract ability? Sure, let's do that. You don't want to be here? It's all right. We'll just heal the party a little bit. All right, Tidus, now it's your turn.
See ya.
He's more enthusiastic about that.
Told ya.
What did you tell me, Tidus? I don't think you said anything that I heard. I have to give him a hard time. Level 1 key sphere times 3. Is that a key lock? Does that mean they're telling me that I should actually go ahead and get those extra stats? Practicing learning to harmonize with things. I really think that this might be my favorite song in the game. I really want somebody to do like an 80s Journey style cover of it. I don't know. I have like 11, so I'm not going end game. Oops. At least I'm not gonna do the crazy optional hard stuff. Yes! Yes, that's what it is, Nautilus. Thank you. You are right. Kamari, you're gonna hit the guy in the middle with your base stick? Lulu, you're not going to attack it. You're going to fire it. Ba-da. Go ahead and give it the pink slip. Yo!
Told ya!
I have played Metroid games. I have played Super Metroid and Metroid Fusion, but I didn't beat Metroid Fusion. So you're saying that I should equip things that aren't... Oh. Yeah, actually. More sensor is probably more better. Depends on who's in my party. So if somebody's not there, then I don't listen to it. Super Metroid is an amazing game. It is one of the best games. Oh, is this the old lady? The old
lady.
We
meet again.
Yes.
I heard you took part in Operation Meehan.
Don't shoot me out, please.
You've seen that Machina aren't the answer. In the end, only summoners can hope to defeat Sin.
Hi, Doc.
You are right. I must train harder.
That's a good response.
I can help with that, if you like. I propose a contest of aeons. A friendly contest, of course.
I like her. Well,
I'm ready.
That's the spirit. But before we begin...
She's gonna heal me.
I have healed your aeons. Well, shall we?
Yes, Chrono. Okay, what's strong against lightning is also weak against lightning. Because this game is weird. I love the way it's like spraying! I'm free! Does it have a face?
Call whichever Aeon you want.
It does have a face. Okay, I see. Yeah, except its nose. It's like looking down. It's like its horn is too big for its head. So who do I want to summon? Okay, so I can't summon that. Sorry. That Yuna, it seems like she'd have a stronger bond with Balefor, but Ifrit seems like he's stronger. He's also closer to getting an overdrive. Well, we'll try Balefor, yes. Oh my god, it's so cute! Oh my gosh, it's so cute! Yeah, like this one seems like this one is her special favorite. Immune to sensors, huh? Oh no! That does something.
Don't hold anything back. Show me what you've learned.
I've learned that you have a weakness, and I'm going to take advantage of it. Oh, jeez. This is not gonna work, is it? No way I'm gonna do enough damage to actually kill it. I'm gonna disappoint the Pokemon trainer. She's gonna be like, you have much to learn. You know, be like, I know. She'll feel bad. Can I swap? Nope. Oh, I can. Oh. Cool. I didn't expect that for some reason. Oh, he's gonna pick up and put it on his shoulder! So cute! You can totally swap Aeons though. I love the way he does a flip. Yeah. I'm gonna do a little bit more damage to it. I try to leave that as a finishing blow sort of thing. Because your overdrive doesn't go away. Yeah? Strategy, Lauren, strategy! No. This is gonna be a losing battle. Hope that this won't kill me. Okay, good job! Thank you, Ifrit! This is gonna kill me. I think this is gonna kill me. Oh jeez, no. Ah. Oh. No. Well, I don't think I had a chance at winning anyway. Unfortunately. I'm gonna die. Miserably. The fact that I have multiple Aeons should make it better, but they're both gonna just die. It's gonna be sad. Wait, did my, I thought I had, oh, drat. Ha, that does nothing. I'm gonna die horribly. So I can't heal myself. None of these will heal me. I blew it! I blew my chance last. I'm sad about that. I guess we'll try again. This won't be enough to do it. This is like my only chance. This is my only, my last thing. It's not gonna make a difference. Tragically. Yeah.
Still wet behind the ears, but you have spirit.
Dude.
Here, your prize. Go on, take it.
I learned a few more things about, possessing the summoner's soul allows him to learn abilities by expending items. Select abilities. Select an Aeon. How do I learn? Wait. Wait, hold on. Do I have to equip that on, you know? I can't do abilities with Ixion either. Aha! There we go. Okay, so you can get them to drop spears too. Ha! Nice. Oh my goodness, you can get them to learn like almost anything. Thank you. healing does seem like it would be useful. But I can't do that for some reason because I don't have enough potions. Or am I too low level? It does not appear that he can learn Furaga. At least not on here. Bye, Doc. Good luck at work. Who? Seeing as I really like Balefor, I really do, but I don't actually know if she's particularly useful. I'd like to give one of them Dark Attack. I guess I can figure out which one I want to give stuff to. Wow, this takes a lot of spheres. Who should I give that to? I'm gonna take a brief bathroom break for just a moment. If you guys happen to have a suggestion on which of the three, light hint, if there's a thing that I should keep in mind. I'll be right back. I'm back. See, for all you guys know, I've just been like sitting here this whole time because I have a Be Right Back screen, so you don't know. Yeah, maybe I'll just hold off on that and not worry about it right now. I guess I should probably have Yuna heal herself.
Ooh.
I don't want to disappoint that lady when I face her again. Alright, Waka. I'm pretty sure this thing is immune. But we're gonna try it anyway. Immune. Right, there's other enemies. I need to remember that I fight those things. Yeah. Okay, Lulu, you're going to fire up. This would actually be a pretty good one to have. Wait, is Kamari poisoned?
So who's next?
Probably the gigantic thing in front of you, Oran. Just going out on a limb here. I have to sass him. I just require it. I'm sorry, friends. Oh yeah, that's totally like Marlboro. Ooh boy. Well, fortunately, Lulu seems fine, so she'll just set it on fire. Is Oran blind? Yeah. No. Oh no, I'm muted. That's not good. Echo screen. Okay, I should probably. Get more of those.
All right.
Hey, JRPG Chief. You did make it. No, don't kill Waka. Titus. Attack. Ha! Bam. Lulu, set it on fire. Unfortunately, Ifrit is out of commission.
You like that?
I did not that expect. Lauren, English is hard, apparently. Alright, sorry, Oran. You're a little bit behind, buddy. Should probably start getting some, what's that called? Ability spheres. Map. Mini map. Mini map. Uh-oh. Wind chimes?
Whoa!
Oh, this can't be good. Those are souls. Does Yuna need to send to ascending here? What happened?
This is the moonflow.
Oh, okay.
These are moon lilies.
They look like souls are coming out of them. I'm concerned.
They say that clouds of fireflies gather here when night falls.
The entire river glows like a sea of stars.
Really?
Ooh, that is really pretty sounding.
Hey, I got an idea!
Oh no, don't go jumping in the magic water.
We're not waiting till nightfall.
Nah. Then, once we beat Sin, we're coming back.
This is the most awkward silence the game could possibly have. Yeah, Titus, things are gonna end badly, and everybody but you knows it. I may not know exactly how, but I suspect that several of us are gonna be asked to sacrifice our lives. for this.
Hey, we better hurry or we'll miss the Shoopuf.
Shoopuf? That's some kind of boat?
Oh my god, how adorable! Look at that! Titus is like standing up. Oh my god, that was adorable. Is Titus really short or is Walker really tall? I feel like Titus towers over the girls. And Walker towers over Titus, so. It doesn't look that far from Nightfall, but I guess then we won't get to ride the thing we want to ride.
Whoa! What the? Whoa!
It can be this. Can this be as weird as the thing in 9? Holy crap! Wait, it's an elephant! Okay, I'm pretty sure that I got stuck in the first cloister because I don't remember seeing an
this
elephant dinosaur.
This is a Shoopuf.
Whoa! Let's ride! Come on, let's go!
All right, we board soon as we're ready, huh?
The song tells me that something annoying is gonna happen here.
Oh, Walker, at your service.
I might as well buy a couple of these. A couple of those. Just cause like, yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
Shoopuffs! I haven't ridden one in so long.
What? You've been on one of these?
Well, just once. 10 years ago, with Kamari. Remember?
Shoopuf shook. Yuna fall in water. Shoopuf scoop up Yuna with long nose.
Aww.
Yuna jump in 3 more times for fun.
That's really cute. I bet that this was after her
Kamari
dad.
Kamari worried.
Whoops.
Ah!
Yuna had fun. Kamari happy.
That's really cute.
I lived in the city of Bavel until 10 years ago. I moved to Besaid after my father defeated Sin. Kamari was with me the whole way.
Interesting.
Bavel?
It's the biggest city in Spira. The main temple of Yevon is there. Come on, let's get on the Shoopuf.
Biran is troublemaker, but Ronso, do not lie. Summoners disappearing, that was not lie.
Right, I'll be careful.
You're dead.
Smells like oil.
Oh, Machina?
Smells like oil.
Interesting. We don't know yet, Careless Dragon. Okay, there's a blue dude. Let's start with this corner.
No, I don't think so. It's a bad idea, yes?
Oh, it's a water.
Please, we beg of you.
Impossible!
Oh my god.
What's wrong?
It's a fish dude.
This guy won't let our chocobo on the Shoopuf.
Ah, it is kind of big.
It's just not fair.
He does have a point, though.
So what? We just leave him behind?
Hey, I didn't say that. Just...
It is no good. We will have to find another way.
Oh, he's a
we
bug
will find
person.
A ford where we can cross on foot. Yes, Captain Sir.
But that'll take days.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
Oh, boy.
That's our captain. Yeah.
Oh, buddy.
Where there's a will, there's a way. Those words stayed with me.
That's funny, Colonel.
I wonder how Captain Lucille is doing.
I played that game a lot. Look, Ampy, if you're like a professional chocobo rider, you can jump off on a chocobo like nobody's business. Oh my god, is this?
Would you like to hear a bit about the wondrous Shoopuf?
Yes, I absolutely would.
Very well.
I'm glad that
there are many things we do not know about the Shoopuf. For example, what does it eat? It eats nothing.
It sounds delightful.
The water it sucks through its schnoz somehow supports its considerable size. Some theorize it eats teeny-weeny waterborne organisms. And that, as they say, is that.
Oh my god.
Perhaps you'd like to hear a bit about the Hypello,
Yes, absolutely.
The Shoopuf handlers belong to a race of water dwellers known as the Hypello. They may be slow on land, but in the water they're quick as silvery fish. You'd think they'd make admirable players of blitzball.
That's, of course, our priority.
But their lackadaisical disposition draws them to less strenuous pastimes.
Oh, my God.
And that, as they say, is that.
Oh, my gosh.
I believe I've said all there is to say.
I love the little, like, sound of approval that he makes sometimes when like, he, like, recites a bit of information, and just, like, he's just like, information is delightful. This one, piercing and dark touch. Oh my gosh, it's another weapon. Okay, I'm getting this. Unless there's a particular reason why I shouldn't get this. This is like exactly what I want. It's a new weapon for Oron that lets him blind enemies, which is pretty great because blinding is basically my favorite status thing. It's likely to work. So far, it seems like it's likely to work anyway. Right. Good. Yes. 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 Oh man, this is both Fire Strike and Ice Strike. This seems useful. Is that useful? Much with my money right now, so it seems like I could be able to, that was not really worth it? Okay. Okay. Cool. Yes! I agree, Emily. Wrong button. Oh my gosh, there's an illustration in the background of a Shoopuf. Oh my god, they're cute! I want to make friends with one. Do you think I can make friends with a Shoopuf? Can I have like a Shoopuf buddy? Ride a Shoopuf. Right? That's what we're here for.
Let the driver know when you're ready. Let the driver know.
Riding a Shoopuf isn't that much fun.
How little you know. Some things little boys never grow out of.
Right?
Oh my god.
The merchants here are wily. Pick your shop well.
Ah, I see. Okay, so there's multiple shops. Yeah, the Chocobos squad told us they were going to go up north to find more Chocobos. Oh, hello, Aura.
10 years ago.
Ah, a history lesson?
Come on, Tina Stravitz, this is about
Jack
you now.
Jack saw his first Shoopuf here. Surprised, he drew his blade and struck it.
Why?
He was drunk. Thought it was a fiend.
Of course.
Oh, brother.
We offered all the money we had as an apology. Jekt never drank again.
That's all.
But it would seem that Shoopuf still works here. Even after 10 years, Spira hasn't changed. Truly, the place seems to resist change. It would take something unusual. Don't let the peaceful scenery fool you. Be on guard at all times. Don't let the peaceful scenery fool.
It does have scars. Yikes. Hi, Nox. Of course. I'm sure that this makes us suspect then, if it has something to do with the oven, who I automatically distrust now. Armor. By the way, guys, there's a cat right here. Nox! Hi, baby cat! Alright. Nox! Nox, meow, 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 meow. Poison ward. Yes, oh my gosh. She has a cat named Aiko, who is like a baby version of Nox. It's very cute. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, things that have wards on them like that are pretty cool, but I also don't keep up with my equipment, so I may very well have things that have those already. I just not know it. Isn't that right, Nox? I'm bad at keeping up with my equipment. Life is hard. One of the things I like about Dark Souls. I don't have to keep up with the equipment. I just wear my swamp clothes and everything's good. Nox, should we get some stuff? Should we do some shopping? Nox thinks I should do some shopping because tomorrow I'm going to go to the pet store and get more wet food. Okay. That's what you guys keep telling me, but I was just really excited because I haven't gotten any other sword for Oron, and that one just seemed like a very good fit. In her case, it's Aiko, like the character in Final Fantasy IX, but that is a good game. Pretty nice with the swirl pattern. What have you got, buddy? Difference. How on earth are your machines? How do they have Yevon's approval? Like what?
Rides is Shoopuf?
Not yet.
Shoopuff's waiting.
Oh my god. I'm sorry, guys. Whatever, I'm better than my dad. Well, that's because it is Rose of May, but people translate it badly as Loss of Me, but it's actually Rose of May. The other version of her theme is called Protecting My Devotion. Rose of May and Loss of Me, that is Americans trying to translate the Japanese sound in. It does somewhat. Protecting My Devotion is not the fast name? Not the fast theme's name? Yeah, Rose of May is the slow theme and Protecting My Devotion is the fast theme. Unless there's something I don't know about that soundtrack. Sorry, guys, we're having a Final Fantasy IX. Shall we ride the Shoopuf?
Rides the Shoopuf?
think I've talked to everybody. Shall we do this? Shall we rise the Shoopuf? Alright. I'm gonna hate this.
All aboard!
Makes me think of the bugs. The upside down bug carriage in 9.
Shoopuf launching!
They don't... Maybe I don't have to do anything here. Maybe I just sit back and relax and enjoy the ride, and Sin is certainly not going to come up in the middle of this river and attack me. Gargant! That's right. Gargantula Antulas.
Hey.
Huh?
Take a look.
What?
Oh, are we talking about Ariton's covers? I love her. She's one of my favorites. She's probably my favorite YouTuber. Unfortunately,
a sunken city.
Kind of gone MIA. Oh no, another one of these.
City, 1,000 years old.
Another one?
They built the city on top of bridges across a river.
But the weight of the city caused the bridges to collapse, and it all sank to the bottom.
Right, it's a good lesson.
A lesson?
Yeah. Why build a city over a river, yeah?
Well, it would be convenient with all that water there.
Nope, that's not why. They just wanted to prove they could defy the laws of nature.
I'm not so sure about that.
Yevon has taught us. When humans have power, they seek to use it.
Oh dear.
If you don't stop them, they go too far, yeah?
Yeah, but don't you use Machina too? Like the stadium and stuff, right?
Yevon, it decides which Machina we may use, and which we may not.
Huh. So what kind of Machina may we not use, then?
Remember Operation Meehan? That kind.
Or war will rage again.
War?
Oh dear.
More than 1,000 years ago...
Oh, maybe this is the origin of
mankind
sin.
...mankind waged war using Machina to kill.
They kept building more and more powerful Machina.
They made weapons so powerful... It was thought they could destroy the entire world.
All right.
The people feared that Spira would be destroyed.
But the war did not stop.
Did they make Sin as the ultimate
what
weapon?
What happened then?
Sin came, and it destroyed the cities and their Machina.
The war ended, and our reward was Sin.
Okay.
So, Sin's our punishment for letting things get out of hand, eh?
Man, that's rough.
Yeah, it is.
But it's not like the Machina are bad.
Only as bad as their users.
Yeah.
It's because of people like the Albed screwing everything up.
What could that be?
Oh my god, he kind of looks like Katamari.
Sit down.
Sorry! Ah!
The Albed!
Oh dear.
Luna, we'll save you!
What is that? It's like a mechanical octopus that they put Yuna into? The heck? Guys, why do they keep trying to kidnap Yuna? What is going on? Alright. Of course, these are my only two characters who can go underwater. Well, Nautilus, isn't it like 3 in the morning your time? Shouldn't you be sleeping? Although it does kind of have a Team Rocket feel to it. Extractor. I guess it's extracting her. Oh, levels of light. Yeah, I got it. Not that it makes much difference, unfortunately. Writing depth charges? That doesn't sound like something I want to have happen. Well, it's not going to heal it. So yeah, we're just going to try really hard to get lightning. Ah, no, no. Okay, well, there's a little bit of lightning there. Could be worse. I do not, in fact, have lightning touch. All right, well, I guess I'm just gonna hit it. Let's go back up. What is the deal here, thing? What are you doing, thing? Being depth charge. Did not seem like that was a hard fight, which makes me think there's probably going to be a second one. Oh, does it replace items with those? Okay. Well. Oh, Yuna's present in the fight. That's really cute. Well, oh well. I don't know what I'm doing.
Are you hurt?
Her poor clipping hair.
No, I'm fine.
Oh, gah, those outbed.
Ish everybody okay?
I'm sorry, we're all okay now.
Yuna.
He didn't even know.
Shoopuf, full speed ahead.
the guy didn't even notice that, like, one of our characters got, like, stolen by a machine.
Damn the outbid! What do they want from us? Could it have something to do with Luca? What are they after Una for? Wait, they're mad they lost the tournament. Oh, wait! They're mad about Operation Meehan!
I wonder... Didn't Kamari's clansman say something about summoners disappearing?
Ah, so the outbet are behind that. Those
sandblasted grease monkeys is a pretty good insult. Is everybody thinking the same thing here?
Hey, Waka. It's no use complaining about the outbet now, right? We'll protect Una from anyone, anywhere. It's that easy. That's all I need to know.
Well, I guess so.
Huh.
You're right.
Is that supposed to be her mouthing that at Titus? Like whispering? We made it! Okay, that was actually not nearly as annoying as I thought it was going to be. I thought I was gonna have to do some sort of crazy, like, creeping around song. Oh, hello! What do you wonder? Why? You can't just say that and not tell me why.
Kimari fail as guardian on Shoopuf. Kimari never fail again.
You're right, Chrono, it is bedtime, and I do need to do laundry and clean my house. Okay. Are you sure, Emily? Okay. Labraska and Guadus along? Wait a minute, wait, what? But...
Might be more out bed. Keep watch, yeah? Might be more...
Looks like we're stuck here for a while. Looks like we're stuck here for a while.
On the far plane, okay, yeah. Nox wants food. Nox, you're gonna have to sit down, baby cat. Sit down, baby cat, sit down.
Yourself.
What's he got indeed? He seems kind of suspicious, huh? Oh, hello, friend.
Guard Una. Guard Una.
I will. What? Hold on, wait. Wait, what? Okay, where is Guadu Salam and the dead are there? Hold up, that doesn't make any sense. Feel the warmth of the people? The body's perfection, huh? Yes, that's right. That's the spirit. It is your life. You make the decision that's right for you. So these are the Guado. Huh. They have really long arms and big hands. Weird ears, a unusual hair. I see. Okay, so Seymour's hair definitely comes from the Guado side of, of his family. Plant people. Yeah, I don't know. Just making sure I haven't missed, like, treasure chests or things. Not that, like, they matter or anything. Like, not like there's actually any risk of... The Shoopuf doesn't seem to be sleeping, but I guess it is. Oh, there's a treasure chest here. Hello, treasure chest. Am I here alone? Holy wait, what? Oh no, it's Rikku.
You're not dead?
Gratuitous butt shot, I see. Oh my gosh, are you serious?
Thought I was done for back.
Wait.
Rikku! You're Rikku! Hey! You're okay! How you been?
Terrible.
Yeah, you don't look so good. What happened?
You beat me up, remember?
Oh my god, wait, were you trying to steal her?
Oh, that machina? That was you?
She's definitely the same character type as Yuffie. I don't like that archetype very much.
Oh, that really hurt, you know. You big meanie.
Wait, but you attacked us!
Nuh-uh. It's not exactly what you think.
Yo!
Oh dear, this is not going to go well.
Friend of yours.
And you could say that.
Pleased to meet ya. I'm Rikku.
Yuna? Lulu? I told you about her, remember? She was the one who helped me before I was washed up on Besaid. She's an Albed.
Oh no.
Oh.
Wow, so you like... Or your life. What luck
oh,
meeting
wow.
here, yeah?
He totally made it.
Praise be to Yevon.
Totally fooled Waka on that. Wow.
So, Rikku.
Does she not have the
you
eyes?
Look a little beat up. You okay?
Waka.
Huh? What?
There's something we need to discuss.
Oh, go ahead.
Girls only. Boys, please wait over there.
Right. Sorry, Waka.
Huh?
Wait,
what?
Wait, wait, do they know her?
Sir Orin, I would like Rikku to be my guardian.
Wait, 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 what? Hold up, wait.
Show me your face.
Huh?
What, is she got
look
going
at
on
me.
Her hair?
Oh, okay.
She's got little feather things?
Open your eyes. As I thought.
No good?
Are you certain?
100%. So, anyway, can I?
If Yuna wishes it.
Yes, I do.
She sounds happy, though. Like, she sounds genuinely
Rikku's
happy.
She's a good girl. She helped me a bunch.
Well, I'm for it. The more the merrier.
Righto. Then I'll just have to be the merriest.
It was strange. Even though Waka had always hated the Albed.
Rikku, at your service.
He never realized Rikku was one of them.
Oh dear, Waka. Oh my. Okay, well, that was really weird. That was really weird, like... The girls have a girl talk. I guess they must know her. I mean, I guess Yuna's half Albedian, right? Or part Albedian, so maybe she does know her. I have a hard time. There you go, Chrono. Yeah, no. I just really don't like the archetype that she is, which is actually really interesting because Aiko, or however you're supposed to pronounce her name, Aiko, from 9, I thought was going to be that archetype too. Except she's actually a little girl, and it's less annoying. The little girls are annoying than when, like, 16-year-old girls act like 5-year-olds. I think she's about 8, 6, really young. But she's actually fantastic. She's a great character. She totally seems like a trope and then isn't. No, CB, but because Yuna is part Albed makes it less random for her to know this random person. Like, because it does seem like she knows her. I'm like, oh, well, she might actually know her through her family. So. Score Dreamer. Yes, stream is about to end. I'm sorry. We go until 10. We went a few minutes over this time because there was a story scene that I had to go see. Unfortunately. I've got to do laundry and feed my cats and clean. Yeah, no, it is, because there's something about people have this idea of somebody being like, God, what's the word for it? I don't remember what it is, but having the two colored eyes or two colored pieces being from being two different kinds of creatures. Because that happens a lot. Something about playing soccer in a ball of water. Yes! Not at this very moment. We are not playing Blitzball at this very moment. But there is definitely a lot of underwater water soccer. Heterochromia! Oh my god, Jinx, all three of you guys. Well done. But it doesn't work that way where, like, your dad has a blue eye and your dad has blue eyes and your mom has brown eyes and so you have one of each, right? Like. I suppose you're welcome. Oh, it is a form of chimerism. Okay, never mind. I'm familiar with that. Isn't that, calicos or tortoise shells, cats or something like that. Oh, really? Okay, serious ink. Well then. Clearly you're half Albed too. Thank you for following. Oh, are they? Because my sister's eyes are hazel, and that it's hard to say what color they are. They seem to change depending on her age and what she's wearing and the weather. Oh, is that what I'm thinking of, Sirius Inc? Okay. I knew there was something significant on a genetic level about either calicos or tortoise shells. That's why you only ever have female calicos, right? Like, it's literally impossible to have a male calico cat. I'm not an expert, I just know there was a thing that I heard once, I just don't remember what the thing was. It counts, right? Oh, speaking of cats. Yes, baby cat, Nox is sitting here on my desk. Oh, they can exist, okay, they're just not. Oh, man, that's complicated. Science is so cool. Oh, okay, that makes sense. All right. Huh. My keyboard seems to be broken. That's not good. Well, I was going to do... Oh, man, somebody else is going to have to do the Discord and social media things because my keyboard is entirely broken. Oh my god, seriously. Okay, well, you and your science facts are very impressive, and I'm impressed. So, there we go. I'm glad that we've ended the stream on cat facts. Again, I'm playing this game at least partly because of Emily. Is it Asia or Asea? And she's also really obsessed with cats. So I think it's appropriate to talk about cats while doing a Final Fantasy X stream. Thank you, Nick. Nox! 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 Oh my gosh, she's such a cutie. It's just exclamation point social. I'm gonna try to get it so that those things cycle through on a timer. Oh my goodness. There you go, thank you. All right, so a little bit of speculation about what happens next. Now I have no idea, except we're just gonna keep going to temples and getting things, and then we'll find out exactly how bad and evil the supposed good guy is. But everything has very unsubtly indicated that that's the case. Nicely done, Chrono. Nicely done. Well, in that case, I will shut down. I will be back on Thursday with more Dark Souls. I should probably draw the picture of last week's Dark Souls thing first. And then I will be back on Saturday with music. And there's gonna be music streams, and I'm gonna put music up on my YouTube channel, so yes, it should be good. Good night, everybody. I'm glad you could drop by. I'm super excited we had some new friends come by. That's always exciting. So just keep in touch. That's all right, Sirius Inc. We can always let you know what you've missed. Bye, folks. Bye.